Mga petang, saudara dan saudari, dalam nama Tuhan Yesus Kristus, ucapan selamat datang ke Misa Soft Opening Gereja Baru St. Anne. Yang merayakan Misa Kudus kita pada petang ini ialah Yang Mulia Archbishop Simon Paul dan dirayakan bersama dengan Yang Mulia Archbishop Emeritus John Hall. Hari ini ialah Hari Raya Santa Pro Maria di Kandong Tanpa Dosa. Marilah kita sama-sama berdiri untuk menyanyikan lagu Let Us Go to the Altar.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good evening, sisters and brothers in the Lord. Tidak rasa seperti kita di Batu Sepuluh sini, kan? It is a very wonderful experience to gather for the first time as a body of Christ to have the soft opening with the blessing of St. Anne's Baruch Church. So with this, we would like to bless the baptismal water and then the besprinkling of blessing of this place. Brothers and sisters in Christ, in the solemn rite of blessing, let us ask the Lord our God to bless this water created by His hand. It is a sign of our repentance and a reminder of our baptism. May the grace of God help us to remain faithful members of His church, open to the Spirit we have received. Let's pray for a moment. God of mercy, you call every creature to the light of life and surround us with such great love that when we stray, you continually lead us back to Christ, our God. For you have established an inheritance of such mercy that those sinners who pass through water made sacred die with Christ and rise restored as members of His body and heirs to His eternal covenant. Bless this water. Sanctify it. As it is sprinkled upon us throughout this church, make it a sign of the saving waters of baptism, by which we become one in Christ, the temple of your Spirit. May all gathered here today and all those in days to come who celebrate your mysteries in this church be united at last in the holy city of your peace. We ask this in the name of Jesus the Lord. Amen. We will now sprinkle the church together with all the priests. Archbishop Emeritus will go around the church and bless this building. May God, the Father of mercies, dwell in this house of prayer. May the grace of the Holy Spirit cleanse us, for we are the temple of His presence. Amen.
Gloria Pada Alla di Sorga. Kediaman yang layak bagi puteramu, sebagaimana engkau telah membebaskan dia dari setiap noda dosa. Semoga berkat doanya, engkau pun memperkenankan kami sampai kepadamu dalam keadaan suci murni. Dengan pengantaraan Yesus Kristus Putera-Mu, Tuhan kami, yang bersama dengan Dikau dalam persatuan Roh Kudus hidup dan berkuasa, Allah sepanjang segala masa. Amin.
Let us be seated as we listen to the Word of God.
Pembacaan dari Kitab Kejadian. Pada suatu hari di Taman Eden, setelah Adam makan buah pohon terlarang, Tuhan Allah memanggil manusia itu dan berfirman kepadanya, "Di manakah engkau?" Ia menjawab, "Ketika aku mendengar bahwa engkau ada dalam taman ini, aku menjadi takut Karena aku telanjang, sebab itu aku bersembunyi. Lalu Tuhan berfirman, siapakah yang memberitahukan kepadamu bahwa engkau telanjang? Apakah engkau makan dari buah pohon yang kularang engkau makan itu? Manusia itu menjawab, perempuan yang kau tempatkan di sisiku, dialah yang memberi dari pohon buah itu kepadaku, maka ku makan. Kemudian berfirmanlah Tuhan Allah kepada perempuan itu, apakah yang telah kau perbuat ini? Jawab perempuan itu, ular itu yang memperdayakan aku, maka ku makan. Lalu berfirmanlah Tuhan Allah kepada ular itu, karena engkau berbuat demikian, terkutuklah engkau di antara segala ternak dan di antara segala binatang hutan. Dengan perutmulah engkau akan menjalar, dan debu tanahlah akan kau makan seumur hidupmu. Aku akan mengadakan pemusuhan antara engkau dan perempuan ini, antara keturunanmu dan keturunannya. Keturunannya akan meremukkan kepalamu, dan engkau akan meremukkan tumitnya. Manusia itu memberi nama Hawa kepada istrinya, sebab dialah yang menjadi ibu semua yang hidup. Sabda Tuhan.
Katakan karya agungmu Tuhan, karya agungmu, karya keselamatan.
Aku katakan karya agungmu Tuhan, karya agungmu, karya keselamatan.
Nyanyikanlah lagu baru bagi Tuhan, sebab Ia telah melakukan karya-karya yang ajaib. Keselamatan telah dikerjakan oleh tangan kanannya, oleh lengannya yang telah memperkenalkan keselamatan yang datang daripadanya. Ia telah menyatakan keadilannya di hadapan para bangsa. Ia ingat akan kasih dan kesetiaannya terhadap kaum Israel.
Aku katakan karya
segala ujung bumi telah melihat keselamatan yang datang dari Allah kita. Bersorak-sorailah bagi Tuhan, hai seluruh bumi, bergembiralah dan bermazmurlah.
Aku katakan karya agungmu Tuhan, karya agungmu, karya keselamatan.
Pembacaan dari surat Rasul Paulus kepada jemaat di Efesus. Saudara-saudara, terpujilah Allah dan Bapa Tuhan kita Yesus Kristus yang dalam Kristus telah mengaruniakan kepada kita segala berkat rohani di surga. Sebab di dalam Dia Allah telah memilih kita sebelum dunia dijadikan, supaya kita kudus dan tak bercacat di hadapannya. Dalam kasih, Ia telah menentukan kita dari semula untuk menjadi di anak-anak-Nya oleh perantaraan Yesus Kristus, sesuai dengan kerelaan kehendak-Nya, supaya terpujilah kasih karunia-Nya yang mulia yang dikaruniakannya kepada kita di dalam Dia yang dikasihinya. Aku katakan di dalam Kristus, karena di dalam Dialah kami mendapat bagian yang dijanjikan Allah, yakni kami yang dari semula ditentukan untuk menerima bagian itu sesuai dengan maksud Allah, yang di dalam segala sesuatu bekerja menurut keputusan kehendak-Nya. Dengan demikian, kami yang sebelumnya telah menaruh harapan pada Kristus, ditentukan-Nya supaya menjadi pujian bagi kemuliaan-Nya. Sabda Tuhan.
Maria penuh rahmat, Tuhan sertamu. Terpujilah engkau di antara wanita.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. He went in and said to her, "Rejoice, so highly favored, the Lord is with you." She was deeply disturbed by these words and asked herself what this greeting could mean. But the angel said to her, "Mary, do not be afraid. You have won God's favor. Listen, you are to conceive and bear a son, and you must name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his ancestor David. He will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and his reign will have no end." Mary said to the angel, "But how can this come about, since I am a virgin?" "The Holy Spirit will come upon you," the angel answered, "and the power of the Most High will cover you with its shadow. And so the child will be holy and be called Son of God. Know this too, your kinswoman Elizabeth has, in her old age, herself conceived a son, and she, whom people called barren, is now in her sixth month, for nothing is impossible to God." "I am the handmaid of the Lord," said Mary. "Let what you have said be done to me." And the angel left her. The Gospel of the Lord.
So as you can see, this is a new church of St. Anne, and we are still finding our movement around this place. It's wonderful to be here today. This Feast of the Immaculate Conception celebrates the solemn belief in the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Why is this feast so important? The Immaculate Conception, according to the teaching of the Catholic Church, is the conception of Blessed Virgin Mary, free from original sin by virtue of the foreseen merits of her Son Jesus Christ. The Catholic Church teaches that Mary was conceived by the normal biological means in the womb of her mother Saint Anne, but God acted upon her soul, keeping it immaculate. And it's appropriate today we bless the Church of St. Anne on this day. The Solemnity of the Immaculate Conception is celebrated on December 8th because there's another feast of Our Lady. The birth or the Nativity of Mary is celebrated on September 8th. So if we do some maths, there's 9 months. So today is the conception of Mother Mary in the womb of Saint Anne, and Saint Anne will give birth to Mary after 9 months. So the church celebrates the birthday of Mary in September the 8th. And we know from the story of tradition, according to tradition, Mary was conceived by her parents called Saint Anne and Saint Joachim. That's why in Batusmong here we have the Church of Saint Anne, and then further up the road, Batu Dua Blas, Batusmong Duo, the Chapel of Saint Joachim. So they are the parents of Mary. They're an elderly couple, according to tradition, who waited and prayed a long time for a child. They grieve their inability to have a child. And today, in a way, the feast falls during this season of Advent. We can see the Advent candle there. We can look at it from the perspective of, together with Anne and Joachim, Mary's parents, they wait in Advent with expectant faith. So our season of Advent, we come here waiting in faith, expectant faith. And we are grateful to God for this new church. We have been waiting for a long, long time, about 3 years. Motui atak mo kajen gereja ti, madinti gereja mo jadi. But still, we have to wait some more because for the whole church to be completed, I heard Father Gerard was asked you to berjaga-jaga di kawasan gereja ini because there are still things are being constructed. But in the, from the point of our faith, we see Mary as somebody very high, as if she is not affected by the difficulty, the challenges of life. That, unfortunately or fortunately, is not the case. Mary is given the gift so that she can raise up Jesus. Today's first reading talks about original sin, how the first man had sinned, and how the first woman had also sinned. God, to overcome sin, offered his son, the new man in Jesus, who died on the cross, who cleanses from all our sin. And then we have Mary, the new Eve, who, by God's grace, was preserved from the stain of original sin. The Gospel speaks about the annunciation of the angel Gabriel to Mary. And we know every Sunday we say the Shahadat, she conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit. She conceived Jesus, conceived Jesus in her womb. And so Mary was prepared without original sin so that her womb is not affected by original sin. And as such, when the Son of God, Jesus, came to be conceived in the womb, he too is not affected by sin. And Jesus is in every respect like us human, but sin. And so the gift of Mary that is given to you and I is not Mary is so special, but rather we also receive the same gift to be free from original sin at baptism. And I'm glad that right in the center there is the baptism pool. Through baptism, we are freed from original sin. We are given new life. We were anointed with the oil of chrism, united with God's people, a member of the church as priest, prophet, and king. And so we are invited by our baptism to walk as children of light. Our baptism makes us children of God. And it's so good to be here today, because in St. Anne's old church up the hill, when we smayang, some people here, somebody there, some on the other side, we cannot see each other. But today here we are gathered as one family. We look around us, we can see. Yes, even up there, so many of you on the mezzanine floor. As a community, as a family. And so Mary, by baptism, all of us become children of God, we become disciples of Jesus. And Mary gave us that model of discipleship. She said, "Yes, behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according as your word." She trusted. She is a disciple. And she's not just a disciple when things are easy. She stood at the foot of the cross when it is so difficult in the face of death of Jesus. She remained faithful. She did not give up. She stood by Jesus at the foot of the cross on Mount Calvary. In the upper room at Pentecost, she was there. And there, by the power of the Holy Spirit, the disciples, the apostles, received the Holy Spirit, and there begin a new beginning now for the church, as recorded in Acts of the Apostles. And so, my dear sisters, my dear brothers, it is a joy to be here to celebrate this day. We bless the church here. We want to offer this church of St. Anne on the solemnity of Immaculate Conception of Mary. It is through St. Anne that Mary came to be born in the world. And so I invite you that as we have a new church here, it is not just a building, but it is the community of faith, that we will become the new people of God. We will also, in this season of Advent, wait in anticipation, not giving up hope for the Lord's blessing and His coming. And above all, next year, 26th of July, 2018, is the Feast of St. Anne. Next year in July, we will dedicate the altar and the pillars of the church. We will use the oil of chrism to anoint 12 pillars of the church together with consecrating the consecration of the altar. But in the meantime, this church building has been blessed so that we now, the new community, can start using it for our masses and for our prayers. Of course, the construction will be ongoing and we'll be shifting around, but most likely we'll be able to use part of it and so on. I leave that to the friars here. But we are grateful to God for all the blessings that we receive. And today, let's give thanks to the Lord. Let's honor Mary, our mother, and let's offer this church of St. Anne for the glory of God, for the good of the church, and for all of you who are here and many who have supported. May you too be blessed. Amen. With this, let us now stand and we profess our faith that Mary, on this day, born of the Holy Spirit without sin, conceived by the Spirit without sin, syahadat kita, marilah kita mengakui kepercayaan iman kita dalam syahadat. Aku percaya akan satu Allah, Bapa yang Maha Kuasa, pencipta langit dan bumi, dan segala sesuatu yang dikelihatan dan tidak kelihatan. Dan akan satu Tuhan Yesus Kristus, Putra Allah yang tunggal, Dia dilahir dari Bapa sebelum segala abad. Allah dari Allah, terang dari terang, Allah benar dari Allah benar. Dia dilahirkan, bukan dijadikan, sehakikat dengan Bapa. Segala sesuatu dijadikan olehnya. Dia turun dari syurga untuk kita manusia dan untuk keselamatan kita. Dia dikandung dari Roh Kudus, dilahirkan oleh perawan Maria dan menjadi manusia. Dia pun disalibkan untuk kita. Waktu Pontius Pilatus, dia menderita sampai wafat dan dimakamkan. Pada hari ketiga, dia bangkit menurut kitab suci. Dia naik ke syurga, duduk di sisi Bapa. Dia akan kembali dengan mulia, mengadili orang yang hidup dan yang mati.
kerajaannya takkan berakhir. Aku percaya akan Roh Kudus, Dia Tuhan yang menghidupkan. Dia berasal dari Bapa dan Putera, yang serta Bapa dan Putera disembah dan dimuliakan. Dia bersabda dengan perantaraan para nabi, aku percaya akan gereja yang satu, kudus, katolik, dan apostolik. Aku mengakui satu pembaptisan akan penghapusan dosa. Aku menantikan kebangkitan orang mati dan hidup di akhirat. Amin. Marilah berdoa kepada Allah Bapa kita yang telah membebaskan Maria sejak awal mula dari noda dosa.
Sahutan kita kepada doa umat ialah, Tuhan dengarkanlah doa umat-Mu.
Tuhan.
Bagi gereja Yesus Kristus di dunia, yang merupakan persekutuan orang-orang yang berdosa, namun terpanggil untuk menjadi kudus berkat kasih karunia Allah. Ya Bapa, semoga kemurahan Allah yang tak terbatas menjadi nyata melalui cinta kasih manusiawi kami satu sama lain. Marilah berdoa kepada Tuhan.
Tuhan, dengarlah umat-Mu.
Bagi para imam dan semua orang lain yang bertugas mewartakan kabar baik. Ya Bapa, semoga para pewarta Injil tetap menyatakan kepada dunia bahwa kekuasaan dosa telah dimusnahkan oleh kasih karunia Allah. Marilah berdoa kepada Tuhan.
Tuhan, dengarlah umat-Mu.
Bagi dunia, ya Bapa, semoga dosa yang menampakkan diri di dunia ini dalam pelbagai bentuk dikalahkan oleh kasih kami satu sama lain serta kemampatan kami untuk selalu memperjuangkan perdamaian dan keadilan. Marilah berdoa kepada Tuhan.
Tuhan, dengarkanlah doa.
Bagi kita sendiri serta mereka yang kita cintai. Ya Bapa, semoga kebaikan di dalam diri kami lebih kuat daripada kejahatan yang ada dalam diri kami dan orang-orang di sekeliling kami. Marilah berdoa kepada Tuhan.
Tuhan, dengarkanlah doa umat-Mu.
Allah segala rahmat, rancangan-Mu terhadap dunia serta manusia melampaui segala dugaan kami. Semoga kami tetap percaya kepada kekuatan kasih-Mu yang menyelamatkan sehingga seturut teladan Bunda Maria. Kami selalu berani memberikan diri kami sepenuhnya kepada Putera-Mu, Yesus Kristus, Tuhan kami, kini dan sepanjang masa.
Umat diminta berdiri.
Blessing of the altar. Brothers and sisters, our community rejoices as it comes to bless this altar. Let us ask God to look kindly on the church's offering placed upon it and to receive his people as an everlasting gift. Blessed are you, Lord, our God, who accepted the sacrifice of Christ offered on the altar of the cross for the salvation of the world. Now with the Father's love you call upon your people to celebrate his memory by coming together at his table. May this altar which we have built for your holy mysteries be the center of our praise and thanksgiving. May it be the table at which we break the bread, which gives us life and drink, the cup which makes us one. May it be a fountain of everlasting, of unfailing waters of salvation. Here may we draw close to Christ, the living stone, and in him grow into a holy temple. Here may our lives of holiness become a pleasing sacrifice to your glory. Blessed be God forever.
Please be seated.
Sekarang kita akan mendengarkan notis gereja. Yang pertama, sakramen pengakuan dosa musim Advent akan diadakan di Gereja Baru St. Anne pada 10 Disember 2017 mulai jam 2 petang. Umat juga digalakkan untuk membuat pengakuan dosa pada setiap hari Ahad, mulai jam 9 pagi hingga 10 pagi, dan pada hari Sabtu, mulai jam 5.30 petang sebelum Misa Senja. Yang kedua, Parti Christmas Kanak-kanak. Kepada kanak-kanak yang telah mendaftarkan diri, sila hadir pada hari Sabtu ini, 9 Disember 2017, di Pusat St. Lucas mulai jam 7 pagi. Yang ketiga, Christmas Carol by Candlelight akan diadakan di pekarangan Gereja Baru St. Anne pada hari Isnin 18 Disember 2017 jam 7.30 petang. Yang terakhir, Kempen Menderma Darah akan diadakan di Bilik Infant Jesus pada hari Ahad 17 Disember 2017 mulai jam 9 pagi hingga jam 12 tengah hari. Untuk lagu persembahan kita akan menyanyikan lagu Kami Bawa Korban.
Thank you. Allah saudara-saudari supaya persembahanku dan persembahanmu berkenan pada Allah Bapa yang Maha Kuasa. Ya Allah, sudilah menerima korban keselamatan yang kami persembahkan kepadamu pada hari raya Santa Perawan Maria di kandung tanpa dosa. Semoga berkat doanya kami pun bebas dari segala dosa, sebab kami percaya bahwa karena rahmatmu dia bebas dari setiap dosa dengan pengantaraan Kristus Tuhan kami. Tuhan bersamamu. Marilah mengarahkan hati kepada Tuhan. Marilah bersyukur kepada Tuhan Allah kita. Sungguh layak dan sepantasnya bahwa kami selalu dan dimanapun bersyukur kepadamu, Tuhan Bapa yang kudus, Allah yang Maha Kuasa dan kekal. Engkau telah melindungi Santa Perawan Maria dari setiap noda dosa asal, untuk mempersiapkan dia yang dipenuhi dengan rahmatmu menjadi bonda yang layak bagi putaramu. Engkau menjadikan dia awal mula gereja, mempelai Kristus yang elok tanpa cacat. Sebab dialah perawan amat murni yang akan melahirkan putaramu, anak domba tak bercela yang menghapus dosa kami. Dia pula lah yang engkau tetapkan bagi umatmu sebagai pengantara rahmat dan teladan kesucian. Dari sebab itu bersama panduan suara para malaikat kami memujimu dan dengan penuh sukacita memuliakan dikau sambil bernyanyi.
Kudus, kuduslah Tuhan, Allah segala kuasa.
Sungguh kuduslah engkau, ya Bapa, sumber segala kekudusan. Maka kami mohon, kuduskanlah persembahan ini dengan daya rohmu, agar bagi kami menjadi tubuh dan darah putaramu terkasih, Tuhan kami Yesus Kristus. Ketika akan diserahkan untuk menanggung sengsara dengan rela, Yesus mengambil roti, mengucap syukur kepadamu, lalu memecah-mecahkan roti itu, dan memberikannya kepada murid-muridnya seraya berkata,
terimalah dan makanlah, inilah tubuhku yang diserahkan bagimu.
Demikian pula sesudah perjamuan, Yesus mengambil piala. Sekali lagi dia mengucap syukur kepadamu, lalu memberikannya piala itu kepada murid-muridnya seraya berkata,
terimalah dan minumlah, inilah piala darahku, darah perjanjian baru dan kekal, yang ditumpahkan bagimu dan bagi semua orang, demi pengampunan dosa. Lakukanlah ini untuk mengenangkan daku. marilah menyatakan misteri iman kita.
Sambil mengenangkan wafat dan kebangkitan Kristus, kami mempersembahkan kepadamu, ya Bapa, roti kehidupan dan piala keselamatan. Kami bersyukur sebab kami engkau anggap layak menghadap engkau dan berbakti kepadamu. Kami mohon agar kami yang menerima tubuh dan darah Kristus dihimpun menjadi satu umat oleh Roh Kudus.
Bapa, perhatikanlah gerejamu yang tersebar di seluruh bumi. Sempurnakanlah umatmu dalam cinta kasih, dalam persatuan dengan Paus kami Fransiskus dan Uskup Agung kami Simon, serta para imam, diakon, dan semua pelayan sabdamu.
Ingatlah akan saudara-saudari kaum beriman yang telah meninggal dengan harapan akan bangkit, dan akan semua orang yang telah berpulang dalam kerahimanmu. Terimalah mereka dalam cahaya wajahmu.
Kasihanilah kami semua agar kami engkau terima dalam kebahagiaan abadi bersama Santa Maria, perawan dan bonda Allah, Santo Yusuf suaminya, bersama para rasul, Santa Ana dan semua orang kudus dari masa ke masa yang hidupnya berkenan di hatimu. Semoga kami pun engkau perkenankan turut serta memuji dan memuliakan dikau dengan pengantaraan Yesus Kristus putramu.
Dengan pengantaraan Kristus, bersama Dia dan dalam Dia, bagimu Allah Bapa yang Maha Kuasa, dalam persekutuan dengan Roh Kudus, segala hormat dan kemuliaan sepanjang segala masa.
Saudara-saudari, mari kita berdiri dengan keyakinan di depan Bapa Syurgawi. Kita telah menerima Roh Kudus yang menjadikan kita anak-anak Allah Bapa Syurgawi. Maka dengan kuasa Roh Allah kita berani berdoa.
Datanglah kerajaan-Mu.
Ya Tuhan, bebaskanlah kami daripada segala yang jahat dan berilah kami damai-Mu. Kasihanilah dan bantulah kami supaya selalu bersih dari noda dosa dan terhindar dari segala gangguan, sehingga kami dapat hidup dengan tenteram sambil mengharapkan kedatangan penyelamat kami, Yesus Kristus. Tuhan Yesus Kristus, Engkau pernah bersabda kepada para rasul, damai-Ku kuwatakan kepadamu, yakni damai-Ku kuberikan kepadamu. Jangan memperhitungkan dosa kami, tetapi perhatikanlah iman gereja-Mu, dan restuilah kami supaya hidup bersatu dengan rukun, sesuai dengan kehendak-Mu. Sebab Engkaulah pengantara kami, kini dan sepanjang masa. Semoga damai Tuhan Yesus Kristus bersamamu.
Marilah kita mengucapkan salam damai antara satu sama lain.
Berilah kami damai, berilah kami damai. Inilah anak domba Allah yang menghapus dosa dunia. Berbahagialah kita yang diundang ke perjamuannya. Ya Tuhan, saya tidak pantas. Tuhan datang kepada saya.
Untuk lagu komuni kita yang pertama ialah I Am the Bread of Life.
I am the bread of life. You come from the shadow of the cross.
Untuk lagu komuni kita yang ketiga, One Bread, One Body. Untuk lagu kesyukuran, kita akan menyanyikan lagu Bonda Maria.
Untuk melahirkan
Let us stand and we pray. Marilah berdoa. Tuhan dan Allah kami, secara istimewa, Engkau telah melindungi Santa Maria dari dosa noda dosa sejak dia dikandung. Semoga sakramen yang telah kami sambut ini menyembuhkan luka-luka dosa dalam diri kami. Dengan pengantaraan Kristus Tuhan kami yang hidup dan berkuasa sepanjang segala masa. Amin.
Umat diminta dijemput duduk. Dijemput Rektor St. Anne, Fraya Jara Victor untuk memberi ucapan alu-aluan beliau.
Okay, selamat malam saudara-saudari dalam nama Yesus Kristus. Dan hari ini kita juga mengucapkan ribuan terima kasih kepada Uskup John Ha, Uskup Simon Po, dan Uskup Emeritus John Ha yang datang untuk meraihkan misa bersama kita pada satu hari yang paling penting, Solemnity of the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Okay. After 39 months, selepas 39 bulan, kita telah datang sebagai satu tubuh Kristus untuk menyembah Tuhan kita dalam gereja baru ini, dan saya paling gembira pada hari ini. So, sekali lagi saya katakan, puji Tuhan. Okay. I thought Sarawak style, when you say puji Tuhan, ada respons. Puji Tuhan. That's Sarawakian style. Huh? So today is the prelude to a better things to come next year. Today we started with Our Lady, and tahun depan yang akan datang kita akan meraihkan Pesta Santa Ana dan Santo Joachim bersama-sama sebagai satu tubuh Kristus. Dan saya mau mengucapkan ribuan terima kasih bagi umat kita. We received the approval from Bomba only on Tuesday, and we worked on an ad hoc basis. This one wasn't planned. Within 3 days, I melihat banyak umat kita dengan penuh kegembiraan datang tampil ke depan untuk menyiapkan gereja kita. And I can't mention all names, but I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart. And sekali lagi, I always got a lot of confidence dalam umat kita dari Paroki Santa Ana yang selalu respons tanpa memikir lebih-lebih. Kamu datang untuk melayani umat kita, gereja kita. Dan selaku rektor, selaku Franciscan, I will tell our bishop tonight, as friars, as rector of St. Anne, we will continue to serve you as our umat here in St. Anne. There are 24,000 lebih umat yang sudah baptized dan sudah daftar dalam banci kita. So it's a big parish. And today, not only me alone, with Friar William, Friar Don Don, and now we have a new face on board, Friar David Au sebagai deacon, dan Friar Kenny and Friar Vernon. I promise to the bishop tonight, we will serve you and we will build our community here, community of faith here in St. Anne. When you look at this cross, this is called the St. Damiano cross. This was a cross that spoke to Francis 800 years ago. Francis was lost. Francis was searching what God wanted him to do. And then he went into one of the chapel and he was praying before this cross. And he heard this voice saying, Francis, go and rebuild the church which is falling into ruins. And Francis, being a very obedient person, straight away went out and built all these broken down chapels, but slowly began to realize God was calling him to build the spiritual house of God, build up the people of God. So for any one of you here, if you got any keraguan, kerisauan dalam hati kita, the cross that spoke to Francis 800 years will speak to any one of you tonight or any other day when you come and pray and ask God for his direction, for his blessing, and for his graces and blessing. Sekali lagi saya mengatakan, sebagai umat Santa Ana, we are very blessed to always have two bishops to celebrate our feast day. Eh? Last feast day also two bishops. Today, soft opening pun, two bishops. And I'd like to thank our two bishops for coming, making time tonight to come and celebrate together with us as one community. And so, my dear people, I think I end here. There are many people to thank for. Okay, maybe I'll just say a few names. I'd like to thank the consultants, our main contractor, Mr. Lokotang from Poly Building, Mr. Arthur from A Design, and all our consultants who have put together, who have come together to build this church. Of course, I say again, our church is still under construction. We are not perfect yet, but we will get there in time. So once again, thank you for coming tonight. I'm very touched. I think the friars here will be very touched by your presence here, because we never expected this big crowd to come tonight, even though today is a working day. So we come, not because of us friars or only the bishop. Huh? We come because our God is here to celebrate together, a very compassionate, loving, and forgiving God. So once again, thank you for your presence. And there's still work to do. It's not the end. Huh? We will continue, as Bishop Simon said, we will continue to build until when this church is ready. Okay, two things in mind for me is the PA system got to come up, and we have to build the pews in this day chapel. And after that, we can come and worship together as a people of God in this beautiful church. So once again, thank you to one and all for the different ministries, for the altar servers. I hope, since we have opened this new church, I hope one of our young men will respond to become a priest to serve the Kuching Archdiocese from St. Anne. Statistics sekarang masih kosong, tidak ada. So I hope with this new church, there are a lot of young men here, the altar servers, and some of you out there, I pray that before I leave, someone will respond to become a priest to serve not only St. Anne, but the Kuching Archdiocese. Thank you.
Dan sekarang, kita menjemput Yang Mulia Archbishop Simon Poh untuk memberi ucapan beliau.
Once again, good evening, sisters and brothers in the Lord. Kada pari kupua pak bori iti mo ramin ti mo talur baka ka. De biati biasa. I thought I balik kampung St. Anne, but come to a new place. I only knew the Baruk for many years. We're happy to be here. And when you sang just now during communion, it is not just I could hear sitting from here. You were all singing as one community, and that precisely is what the church is. We are the body of Christ. And the building is a building that allows us to worship God. So today, we have the soft launching. We bless with holy water the church building and altar and all over the place, or the whole building, and all of you, of course. But we look forward to next year in Feast of St. Anne in July, 26th of July, where we will dedicate and consecrate this whole church. For the dedication and consecration, we will use the oil of chrism,
we will identify 12 pillars, the 12 apostles, and we will anoint the oil of chrism and the altar, and we consecrate the whole house of God, this parish church, to the Lord. And next year, the July 2018, is also the 50th anniversary of the parish of St. Anne. So we look forward to the 50th anniversary, where we implore God's blessing for all of us. Just now, Father Gerard was talking about vocations. I was just preaching about St. Anne and St. Joachim. They were waiting for a child. They waited a long time, and God gave them Mary. So now we are still waiting in St. Anne. One day, young man, inya engan de muda-muda ka, youth ka, dari dayong wa, boleh juga lah. So we have religious vocation to the sisters, and even the Franciscan and priests for the seminary. We pray for that next year. So I'd like to officially also welcome in our midst here today. We know the friars have been here, and we have just one who was ordained only
2 days, 3 days.
3 days ago in Johor Bahru. So this is Deacon David Au. We welcome him to the Archdiocese of Kuching. Birumun ngana siga, agi kakae, Father Felix Au, sudek Father Felix Au. So this is the other brother who joined the Franciscan friars, and he'll be coming to the diocese here as a deacon. So we pray that he will stay on to serve in this Archdiocese of Kuching. So once again, Friar Deacon David Au, welcome to Kuching Archdiocese. Welcome home to Kuching. Lastly, I want to congratulate Frau Gerard, William, Don Don, and all the friars, the fathers who have worked here before, that today we see this church. It is the work that they have, the commitment, and to all of you who has made possible. Tonight, our dream has become a reality. We thank the Lord for that. And of course, our highest glory goes to our God, who has blessed us and who has gathered us together. Today is a weekday. We didn't expect so many of you, but the church is overflowing. And so I thank the Lord for today and ask God's blessing upon all of us tonight. So I invite you all to stand for the blessing. Tuhan bersamamu. Semoga saudara-saudari sekalian diberkati oleh Allah yang Maha Kuasa, Bapa, Putera, dan Roh Kudus. Amin, amin, amin.
Misa Ekaristi sudah selesai. Marilah kita pergi ke dalam damai Tuhan.
Puji Tuhan. Haleluya.
Marilah kita sama-sama. Marilah kita sama-sama melafazkan doa Saint Franciscus.
We adore you, most holy Lord Jesus Christ, here and in all your churches throughout the world. And we bless you because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Marilah kita sama-sama menyanyikan lagu Cahaya Dalam Dunia.
Na na na.
kasih, saudara-saudari, ke atas kehadiran anda. Semoga berbahagia selalu.